Chapter 1, A Child in the Night. Two well-dressed men were about to cross London Street on a sunny Sunday morning. There Mr. Gabriel John Utterson, an elderly lawyer, and his young cousin, Richard Enfield. A horse-drawn hansom cab drew up beside them, and the cabman leaned down from his perch, waving his whip. "Morning, gentlemen," the cabman called with a hopeful smile. "Off to church on this fine Sunday, I'll bet. I'll have you there in 2 weeks or less." Mr. Utterson never spoke, unless it was important. He frowned at the cabman and waved him away, but Richard gave the man a friendly smile and shook his head. "Now, my good man, we are out for a walk, which we take every Sunday. That's the way to see the interesting things in London." They crossed several streets and soon found themselves in a dingy neighborhood. As they slowly walked down a small street full of shops, Mr. Utterson stopped to admire an interesting display in a store window. Suddenly, Richard tugged at his sleeve and spoke with a serious note in his voice. "See that door across the street, cousin? It is involved with something rather old that happened to me." Mr. Utterson looked at the scarred, weather-beaten door Richard was pointing to. It belonged to a two-story building that was one of several built around a courtyard. Because there were no windows at the front of the building, it looked deserted and somewhat sinister. Mr. Utterson's usually indifferent tone of voice took on a note of curiosity. "Indeed? What is that door to you?" he asked. Richard drew him back against the storefront and spoke softly. "I was coming home alone from a party in the dark winter night. There were some lights in the street, but no people. Everyone was asleep, and I heard only my own footsteps. Not far from here, as I need an intersection, I suddenly saw two people. One, coming up on one street, was a little girl, running as hard as she could. And coming up a side street was a short figure of a man, clumping along at a good rate. I saw they were bound to collide at the corner, but there was nothing I could do. It happened very fast. They met with a bang, and the child was knocked off her feet. I heard her cry out. By that time, I was running toward them to help in any way that I could." Richard was so caught up in his story that he did not notice his cousin looking almost fearful as he listened. If he had noticed, he would have stopped talking and been astonished, for Gabriel John Utterson rarely displayed his emotions, even to his many friends. Richard spoke faster now, his eyes flashing. "The man had the wind knocked out of him for a moment, but instead of picking the child up, you will find it hard to believe, cousin, but I swear it's true. He trampled on her, stamped right on her and over her, and continued on his way. The child's screams were terrible. I reached after the man and seized him by a coat collar. The face he turned to me was one hideous snarl. For a crazed moment, I wondered if this was a man or an animal.